All right, so my two yard implements, this Yard Max, it fired right up. I was gonna take this fill to the landfill, but I think I'm just gonna pack it up right here because I'm gonna use it when I do my sidewalk or walkway addition to the front of the house. I'm gonna use this as fill for the low spot, so it's gonna work out perfectly. But I kind of don't want to just leave it sitting in here because I'm not sure when I'm gonna get to it. So I'm gonna run this up there and dump it out. But it was parked right here, so I also want to move them over to the tree line over there. Because we spent a lot of time in this area, and it's not a sore thumb, but it's really. All right, look at these nice green lush trees. But this thing, it's been sitting outside, covered up. So it hasn't been rained on. I just noticed the bat. Well, I presume the battery is dead because I'm not getting anything out of it. Maybe, but not really getting anything positive out of it, so just need to move it. So got my trusty DeWalt here, and I'm gonna crank this up, see if we can get it fired up. Something that I've noticed about this thing is obviously it was repainted. It got a lot of hours on it, and it was definitely repainted, and I'm realizing they might have like paint over some of the grease circ fittings, which is kind of silly. So I'm not sure if I can like clean those out and like apply grease to it at those joints, but it's kind of annoying. But all right, let's go. Red is first to the party. These posts are really small, so I'm not certain if I can get a good bite on it. Keeps catching, but it keeps slipping off also. Alright. Let's see if we can get this thing fired up. Pretty sure this is, I'm not sure which side is high and which one is low. But I think this is high, so we'll leave it in low. It's in neutral, so it's not gonna start rolling back on me. And there's a fuel right there. I was wondering what this cutout was. Oh yeah, it's on. Fuel is on. Haven't really played around with this thing too much, but all right, let's see. How about we turn this thing on? This thing I still might be connected. It's in neutral. Be this choke. Let's try it again. Did she fire it up? She fired up, but I really didn't see the belt spinning. More that when stuff breaks on this, I won't be able to get the parts I need. All right, let's turn this off. I'm gonna say this is a choke right here. It says engine stop. Come on, man. I wonder if I ran out of gas. It's at 12.2, should be plenty. I'm still on the, I'm still getting juice. Might have run out of gas. It looks bone dry in there. Let's try it again. I typically pull this out and it starts. All right, I think we're gonna try to put some gas in here. Try to get the gas can. BRB. All right, we are back with some gasoline, and let's see if I can prop this right up here. Anyway, I'm just gonna fill it up. You can see how kind of corroded it is in there. It's a little bit, slightly concerning. Sounds empty. I'm not sure how much gas this thing takes. It's probably best to just fill it up to prevent condensation. Damn it. Overfilled it, of course. Let's just hope we don't, start a fire. But I definitely overfilled it. I think we're just gonna have to go with it. Just gonna overfill some more. Yeah, it should be below that line. I can see all that gasoline running down. I don't think anything really got on the cylinder head. Looks like it's just dripping down. Where fuel normally leaks out of these anyway. Battery's still on there. We got fuel. Let's see. It's in neutral. Turning, but the belt is not. That doesn't even make sense. Let me go play with it a little bit and see if anything starts moving. feel like it's not doing operating like it should. I mean, see, this thing has been zip tied. Anyway, I'm gonna keep trying to troubleshoot this thing. It doesn't sound like it's running like it should. Keep messing with the controls, but it starts up. The belts are turning. It has this lock right here that locks out these controls, and I know the kids were messing with it, and I noticed that, and so I put the lock on, but now I'm having a field day getting it off. So we're gonna get it. I bought this little digger bucket thinking that it would work, but I think it's a different design. It's for one of those like other Chinese made diggers, so I might be able to take those I don't know what you call it, forks, and put it on that if I wanted to. Take them off, but we'll see. Just want to get this thing started and moved. So, chances are we're just going to have to put the jump pad back on it. Glad I don't have to fight with a clamp hold down, because I keep having to remove this battery. All right, let's just do this again. I know. Not these leads are too big. All right, it might have been a choke. So engine start, stop, you pull this out to stop it. So I think this might be a little bit loose. gotta keep an eye on them. Definitely sounds a lot better. Let's just figure out why this is not moving. I feel like this should have like a little knob on it, a handle, like these light knobs on it. I wonder if I take it out of neutral. I'm gonna take a hammer to it, because it's like right up in here. Oh, I see what's going on. So it's literally a little, where is it at? Right. You can see it right here. It's just this plain piece of popcorn. But they obviously painted it. So I just need to get a hammer. One right here, one right there. So everything should work. Well, obviously not in neutral, but let's rev it up a little bit. I noticed to the left, I think there might be a linkage in here that's bent, because you can see it's sloppy to the left. Like, it doesn't move a whole lot. To the left, it doesn't move a whole lot. Well, it doesn't move fast. So maybe that's something that I can fix later on. And then this is your stabilizer. So works. Now it's time to drive backwards. Yeah, I feel like I could drill this and put these things on there. Or yeah, it looks a little bit smaller. Thing keeps falling off. Gotta secure it. And there you go. She runs. So I'm gonna drive this over there by where the trash can is. Just gotta rake up some of those leaves first. But just kinda wanna clear this area. Backyard is looking way nicer now that I've completed much of the projects. So I moved this thing back in place, and concrete is still a little bit green, and so I kind of scuffed it up, but as you can see, it came out nicely. And then I won't have any at least this gives it time to like get back to normal. I have these like scraps of board, and I'm gonna cut them down, and then I'm gonna use them as shim for my my jacks for my car. So I'm gonna cut these down. I was gonna throw them away, but I'm gonna repurpose them. So we'll get to move this anyway. So here are some of those grease fittings. That one is not painted, but it shouldn't be too bad. I'm gonna get my my grease gun out, and I'm gonna charge these with some grease. You can see this one. I'm not even sure if that has a fitting in there. If I gotta change that one out, looks like I might have to change that one out. I mean, look at this one. It's completely painted over. Yeah, you can see the thing. You can see the little nipple in there. I mean, look at these two. Someone did a horrible job painting this thing. I mean, it's a decent paint job, but these were not meant to be painted over. This, like I said, fires right up. Already have the gas on that side, and it should fire right up. Alright, that's me, I was there. Like, I'm gonna get it.